It is a command of all schools. You are welcome to be a blackness. Put your hands together and clap for Jesus. 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 Clap for Jesus, clap for Jesus, clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus, clap for Jesus, clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus, clap for Jesus, clap for Jesus. Put your hands together and clap for Jesus. Put your hands together and clap for Jesus. Hallelujah. If just because of a sound, the Bible says, Joshua, they lifted up a sound. So just because of the sound, the walls of Jericho, they crumble. So that means even when the Bible says clap, and I didn't say pastor, therefore, pray love, pray point. But just by the obedience of clapping, you will get the miracle. Hallelujah. So put your hands together and clap for Jesus. 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 Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. We are celebrating the King of Kings. Clap your hands, all you people, and shout the voice of triumph. Clap your hands, all you people, and shout the voice of triumph. Clap your hands, all you people, and shout the voice of triumph. Clap your hands, all you people, and shout the voice of triumph. You are Alpha and Omega.
Come on. one in verse 2. Psalm 141 in verse 2 says, let my prayers be set forth as an incense, and the up of my hands, and the lifting up of my hands. So it means when you come to church, I should not beg you to lift up your hands. Because you know why? When you lift up your hands, it says, and the lifting up of my hands as an evening sacrifice. So that means the lifting up of my hands is a sacrifice unto God. So lifting up of my hands is the same as my offering. It is a sacrifice unto God. Cain and Abel, they also go for the sacrifice. Cain was not accepted. Abel was now. Abel was accepted. Now they also come at church. They also go for the sacrifice. But one was accepted, the other was accepted. Why? Because even when we come to church, you don't want to give God the best. You don't want to offer your worship from the depth of your heart the best. So that means we can come to church and someone is there worshiping God from the depth of his or her heart. You just sit up. You watch. And you're seeing someone flowing in the Holy Ghost. You don't understand. So when we lift up our hands, it's a sacrifice to God. So it's so difficult that when you come to church to lift up your hands, you cannot. So that is one sacrifice you're not offering unto God. You are singing the song, you are Alpha and Omega. We worship you. Sit down for just 5 minutes. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Thank you so much, Apostle, for the opportunity. Hallelujah. One for worship God. One for worship God from the depth of your heart. Hallelujah. One for worship God from the depth of your heart. This morning. And I pray that God open the eyes of understanding. We worship. If there's anything you want in the kingdom, is understanding. We kingdom different from other people. We kingdom different from other people. What we have is different. Hallelujah. The Bible says, for the weapons of our warfare, they are not what? They are carnal. So that means in the kingdom we have weapons.
Are they communicate, right?
So that means in the kingdom we have weapons. But the weapons of our warfare, the weapons that we have in the kingdom to fight, to go into battle, they are not physical. Carnal means they are not physical. That means we don't fight our battles with AK-47.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The weapons of our warfare, they're not carnal, but they are mighty through God. So the weapons that we have in the kingdom, one of them is praise and worship. But the most interesting thing is, we get this weapon, and Satan still they oppress you. Now, the devil come against you. You have a weapon of mass destruction, where you don't need for pay for, where you just need for access and use. But because of understanding, you're not able to use your weapon. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you have a weapon that is praise. But when ten rich folk adore the name of so you are so what I would say, reserved. Because when you say it's in my nature, you know, say me, listen like my person, are too, you know, say me too conservative, you know, and not the two wake up to that wedding. Then you still wonder why you see the girl after. You have a weapon. They are not carnal. They are mighty through God. So the pulling down of strongholds. Now I'll just explain to you a few scriptures. We're there for dealing with. Now there are different types of praise. And most of the time we say it is only when we come to sing. Now I'll just explain to you about worship. If I don't go into praise. Worship. You understanding that your level of intimacy with God determines your worship with God. So if your level of intimacy with God and the level of how much you know God is at this level, so it is from this point you worship Him. Because now from this point you understand who God is. You understand? Now from this point you understand who God is. But the moment you get an understanding of who God is at this level, you worship Him at this point. So, I worship God from a point of understanding who He is. I reverence Him. Because I know who God is, when I come to worship, I worship Him from a place of understanding. We mostly then use the scripture, John 4:23, verse 24. There are coming, and now is when the Father seeks for true worship. And they that worship Him must worship Him in what? So, we worship God in, first of all, in waiting. Don't communicate. I believe so. We all understand the Bible. In spirit and in truth. So we worship God in spirit and in truth. In truth. What is the truth? So we say Jesus is the way. So the Word was with God. And the Word was God. So then who is Jesus? The Word. And the Word is what? Truth. The truth is your understanding. This is the Word. We worship Him with the Word of God. So that means even when you come at church, the leader not for the always they tell you, say, lift up your hands. If you understand the Bible, you just get under the Bible. Lift up your hands as an evening sacrifice. We say, clap your hands, all the people, and shout for the voice of triumph. Worship is submission. Is an expression of submission. You express, you show your submission to Him, God. You submit unto Him. I'll try to explain to you what is worship. Worship are your words. Worship is a response. Worship is spirit. We worship God in spirit and in truth. So that means if we worship God in spirit, you made up of what you? You made up of a soul. You have a spirit. You have a soul. You live in a body. But your flesh cannot worship God. Because God is a spirit. So that means your spirit has to worship God. So we worship Him in spirit and in truth. That means your spirit. That means your carnal mind cannot worship God. You have to be in the spirit. You don't have to be in the physical for worship. You have to be in the spirit for you to worship God. And one of the evidence of the spirit is praying in the Holy Ghost. 1 Corinthians 14 and verse 2 says, when we speak in unknown tongues, we speak not unto men, but unto God. When we pray in the Holy Ghost, we speak not unto men, but unto God. Because they understand it not. How be it we speak mysteries? Mysteries, they are the hidden things of God. So that means when you pray the Holy Ghost, He reveals unto you the mysteries, the hidden things. That is why we pray the Holy Ghost. We channel our spirits. We channel our spirits. We worship. Part of the revelation we got shown against. It says, we worship on earth as it is in heaven. Now, how do they worship in heaven? How do they worship in heaven? We all want to go to heaven. But when it comes to church, we're not worshiping in church. First of all, you are so tired. 1 hour, 2 hour. Just tell this man you run now. That's what he said. You don't tell. Boy, you want for go down the street up. You want for kind of street up. You want for go to, you say, you worship. You want to worship there, like eternity. So you are even 4 hours safe of just lifting up the name of Jesus. Because why? You worship in the flesh. The flesh and God, they are enmity. So we worship in spirit. We worship on earth as it is in heaven. Now, how do we worship in heaven? How do we worship in heaven? Revelation 7 and verse 11. Open the Bible, please, to Revelation 7. So this is how we're going to worship this morning. Revelation 7 and verse 11. And all the angels stood round about the throne, and the elders and the four beasts. Now, we know who the angels are. The angels. We know the elders, right? How many elders we get? 24 elders. 24. And we get what you call the four beasts. Now, the four beasts comprises of these are what we call the four faces of God. They all day about round about the throne. One of the beasts, he get the face of a lion. One of the beasts, the other beast, he get the face of a calf. The other beast get the face of a human. And the other one get the face of an eagle. Hallelujah. And they fell before the throne. So now, how do they worship in heaven? They prostrate. So that means it is okay. It is okay for little and gone. It is okay to prostrate. It is okay to bow before Him. For little flat. Forget about your wig. Forget about your shoes. So me, majorly, because I don't want to be I don't want to be tight when I worship him. So now the best I can do, wear shirt, full out. So when I come, to, I can do anything so far. I won't forget the ability to express myself to him. So I won't forget the ability to just lay down. Hallelujah. They fell on their faces. And this is what they do. Now, worship awaiting our words. So we come to him, giving words. We come to him with words. I will tell you for reason, worship is not about singing. Worship is not about singing. Worship are your words. So, Nangome, you need to come from a point where you worship. You sing a song because Sinatra is your favorite artist. So when I sing the songs of Sinatra, I feel emotional. That is not worship. So when I just lift up the song of Edwards, no. It has to be beyond that. Worship me for the beyond my favorite song. Worship me for the beyond the songs you love. You need for the beyond the artist. But let the song make so much meaning to you. So if you say, daily as I live, and often as I breathe, let my whole life be an expression of your grace. So you are saying, daily as I live, every single day that I breathe, let my whole life, let it be an expression. That means, let my whole life show God. So that means, even in the community, let your life show God. How do we express God? How do we express the grace of God? Let them know you are here for that, because for someone that is here, that is what expression God. So even in how to express God? Mark 16 and verse 17. And when we lay hands on the sick, they shall be covered. That is an expression of God. Because His Spirit is in you. You have the Spirit of God. That is an expression. So when you sing the song, you sing it with authority. So you say, daily as I live, and often as I breathe, let my whole life be an expression of your grace. As I live, and often as I breathe, let my whole life be an expression of your grace. We cry like a fire, hallowed be your name. Now, you know, so we sing from the Father, we cry from the depth. You're not just a cry so because of people. Others don't know we cry. But it has to come from within. Now, how can they even cry when somebody died? It comes from your heart. Because you feel it from the depth of your heart. So we cry, Abba Father. All the mechanism in the inside of you, they leap for joy. Hallowed be your name. So these songs, they even make so much meaning to me than just being your favorite artist. That is what worship is. We worship on earth as it is in heaven. They fall down They fell on their faces. What would the elders do? The Bible says they cast their crown. That means they cast their titles. So when we come before God, you need to come before God as a pastor. You need to come before God as a lawyer. You come before Him as a child. Lord, I surrender. This is me, your child. I come before you. You need to come before God in the next time. Forget about your makeup. Forget about your swag. Forget about your swag. Lift up your head, you don't. Prostrate, you don't. Sing, you don't. Okay, so if you didn't come, okay now. If you didn't come, if you didn't come at church, you don't dance. Let me say, God has already put out. If you didn't come at church, you don't worship from the depth of the Bible, say God has also you worship. Now you might not know, say you worship something. But you're worshiping that thing. Even sometimes when you boss, as you boss what you wanted, you don't know. But they're calling at church, you're not gonna be giving excuses. You they come at church, you they guess all kind of, but when you go for interview, you are so put together. When they come at church, because of your understanding. Cain and Abel. Abel was accepted because he gave the best. So if you're giving God your worship, give Him the best. We worship God from the depths of our heart with the best. Your understanding of who God is determines your worship. So even to we music ministers, now in order for dependence on when you come for sing a stage, and I'm telling you, if you say the heavens were open, so then I'm telling you, you are for make sure say you need long, and I'm telling you, no. So what about when the other person is sick, the heavens will be closed? But then as you kind of stage now, and I'm telling you, the power of God, they come, no. We came into His presence to worship. So if we come this morning, lose your flesh and worship Him in spirit. That means the flesh cannot worship God. Anything that is of the flesh, pride. Well, you cannot judge for Nilo, you know what Nilo? That is pride. It cannot worship God. 2 Chronicles 7 says, verse 2, he says, the fire came and burnt down the offering, and then the glory of God came. So that means the fire needs to come and burn every flesh. So the fire precedes the glory. The fire comes before the glory. So for burn every flesh. Every flesh. They cast the crown, they cast their titles, and they worship Him. What are the things you get so much as a title? And God made them give you even a doctor. So if these elders in heaven, they cast their crown, so expensive, they cast their crown. And they fell before their face, they bowed. And they worship Him. They say, worthy is the Lamb that was slain. So receive glory, honor, power, and majesty. All things were made for thy pleasure. And the Bible said the four beasts, they sleep day nor night. They cry, holy, holy is the Lord. This is what we do in heaven. Let you worship, go beyond. you're just waiting in the country, you say, Asia, and you don't know. It is between yourself and God, it's personal. Some of the things, so I like myself, I say, but what does warfare there in Canada? The things of the spirit, they are so foolish. Now, 1 Corinthians 2 and verse 14, the Bible says, the natural man understands not the things of the spirit. That means people in the flesh, they understand not the things of the spirit. So if somebody sees you, they dance some kind of way, he needs to understand that if you're in the flesh. Because in the spirit, you are taking territories. But in the flesh, you understand it not. So even if you see someone is dancing in the Holy Ghost, I need to have a professional dance. No. You are dancing in the Holy Ghost. You are under the influence of the Holy Ghost. In worship, you can't. Because if you natural self, how can I do it? Able, Jesus will say, see, but God is just doing something to activate us. So that means when we worship, when people see you be crazy for Jesus, they don't understand. Because the natural man understands not the things of the spirit, because they are foolish to him. So even when somebody they see they pray the Holy Ghost, they speak in tongues, they get what they want now. I know people when they pray the Holy Ghost, they say they talk nonsense. But when I pray the Holy Ghost, I know I communicate with my Father. Now when you pray in your understanding, you are limited. When you pray, you understand you are limited. When you pray the Holy Ghost, you are limited, because when I pray the Holy Ghost, it gives me utterance. The Bible says that the Holy Spirit, it helps our infirmities, because we know not what we ought to pray for. So when I pray, understand, I will pray. Thank God, bless you. Remember, your word is to be praised. So you are started. I will love you and bless you. You are distracted. But when I pray the Holy Ghost, because your mind does not understand. When you pray the Holy Ghost, your mind only understand. Because it is your spirit and you. So it is not your flesh. So what we're going to do this morning, we're going to pray. Understanding. We're going to sing in the Holy Ghost and we sing in our understanding. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So let me say, I'm not going to tell you how to worship God. I'm not beginning with what they hear you. So now I'm not beginning to explain to you how to worship God. You understand. You know it's going to do for you. You owe it unto Him. We want to see the glory of God this morning. I want to know your ways. I want to touch your grace so I can live your days. I want to see. So I can live on this. I want to see. Exodus 23 and verse 25. It says, worship the Lord your God, and I will bless your bread and your water, and I will take away sickness from you. So now just worship me, and he will handle your bread and water, and he will take away sickness. So why not have that access to him and just worship him, and he takes care of these things? So this morning, we're going to worship him. We want to see his face. Want to see his glory. Want to see his glory. Want to see the glory of God. I'm not going to tell you how to worship. It's between yourself and God. Forget about what you wear. Forget about your composure. Now, this is what you wear. What you don't go through, it's not easy. For then now, for me, be grateful to God. One day, just honor your clothes. Now, I don't know people, they're not staying, they don't get money. Money, they don't come back to the side of the day. Because God elevated you, eat at the pond. Usai, you sacrifice for even more. But then, because you feel, say, at that point, it is by your strength. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lead not from your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him. But because you forget about the acknowledgement of God, now you reach to a point, you don't get money. You don't go for buying clothes. Now the clothes, they stop you not forgetting liberty and presence. Now even the works of the day, even 2 hours prayer, you get there anymore. You worship, you don't anymore. Because if you say the work it's so tedious. You don't say that quantity where I cannot judge. I really need to put myself together.
Thank you.
Ancient of Days, you are glorious in holiness, you are fearful.
See how you appear this young man. Yeah.
to dance away from people before I leave. Just 5 minutes, sir. We're going to dance away to a baby. Now, I'm saying the children of Israel. They went. Now, keep the host apart. Keep the host apart. They're very foolish. As I tell you, the people of the people are very foolish. How did they go home? Did they say, okay, let me put the singers? Or they say, let me take it quiet. Salon they go home. Go first America. No, to America. They're not going to go now. Not Korea. There was no pregnancy, nothing, I was almost in choir. No one couldn't do it. But first of all, one, in worship, it is obedience. In the kingdom, apart from worship, it is obedience. Obedience, that's what God says. Now, every single thing you do in the Bible is obedience to God. Believe in His word and you shall be exalted. Believe in His prophet and you shall what? Prosper. So, your way to your prosperity is through your man of God. So, you believe in the man of God, the grace upon his life. Don't become familiar with grace. So, it was obedience. He went to empower the Lord. Let them lift up their trumpet. Let them lift up their sound. Let them lift up their voice. And the Bible says the enemy that turn against them said, begin killing them. Begin killing them. And then Joshua, the Bible says, just march around the world for 6 days. And on the seventh day, lift up a shout. So when we lift up a shout, when I say shout, you're shouting your way with understanding that when I'm shouting, my problem is gone. When I'm shouting, that word, now, he started like he called and said, the word for Jericho. When I said, okay, not say, no one has seen a chariot. Lord said, we see the two tiny. If you put them together, 8 or 9 of them, put out of the word. You need a book. It is still maintained. So that is how thick the world was. So how thick is that problem? The weapons of warfare are carnal. Praise. Shout. So are we ready to shout? And when you shout, and okay, how you shout, that is how your world is going to crumble. And shout with an understanding. With the Spirit, shout in the Spirit. You are going to dance in the Holy Ghost. Psalm 149 says, praise the Lord with the dance, with your timbre and harp. Hallelujah. So are you ready to shout?
Yeah.
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 Obedience to the word of God. This book of the law shall be upon your body, shall be day and night, and do accordingly all that is in it. Then you shall make your way. So whatsoever we say it is in the Bible, whatsoever is in the Bible, just go on and verse 8. So I never can tell you for sure to be not in the Bible because it has been working for people. So you know for exception. So when we forget if you come on it or not. When God bless you, now with the letters, don't talk about one day. Hallelujah. So are you ready to shout? Are you ready now to make a joyful noise? A joyful noise is not a scripture. So let me say, you want to know and make a joyful noise.
You are singing the song. You are telling God, this is what I want. I want a visa. I want a visa. I want a good business. I want capital. It is coming from my
your trouble has just left you.
shall never. That sickness has just disappeared. Can you say never? If you are in love, you are receiving something. Make some noise!